opposite the wonderful Debbie Gibson in the Hallmark Channel original movie Summer of Dreams. They're teaming up again and reprising their roles in this Saturday's premiere of Wedding of Dreams. Please welcome back the very talented Robert Gant. Good to have you.
Hi, Robert.
Now, before we get to all the fantastic stuff that you are up to, we got to talk about this film. Your character that you played, Noah, obviously, and Debbie in the film, hit it off right away the first time around. Now, where does this, Wedding of Dreams, where does this one pick up with your characters and their relationship?
Well, I mean, the first one, you know, was about us meeting and falling in love and really coming together and deciding we want to, you know, take this journey together.
Yeah.
Now it's about that next stage, and I don't want to give a spoiler, but there may be a wedding in Wedding of Dreams.
And a popping of
the question.
So, right.
But really what happens here is that, you know, like a lot of relationships, you appreciate what works and brings you together, and you deal with the things. Sometimes you have to blend things that were differences. And one of the things in this situation is that, you know, Noah's in a relationship with a pop star, and coming to terms with, oh, okay, what does that mean, and what does the pull of her career mean, and how does that work in terms of the two of them finding a relationship and really taking the long journey together.
And a happy medium. And finding your way to the middle, which you do.
Yeah.
And one thing we definitely know is that Noah is quite the romantic. I love these movies so much.
I learn from them. I'm not going to lie to you.
Do you?
I'm like, man, I got to work on my romance. Yes, she is.
Yeah, he does a great job on the proposal, I have to say. You have to see it.
He really does.
You have to see it.
We have a really sweet clip of the movie where you're sharing a really special moment.
No.
Take a look.
You know what I love about this park?
I don't know.
Happy memories.
Yeah? Like what?
Like when you took me here on our third date.
Mm-hmm.
And you asked me a million questions, but none of them were about showbiz. And I remember thinking that Noah Burns is the greatest guy I've ever met.
Well, that is pretty good. But I think I can top it.
Oh, yeah, I'm listening.
Well, this is where we were when I first knew.
Knew what?
That I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you.
Okay, you win.
It's okay, though. It's okay.
That's so
she got Debbie crying.
Look at,
can we get makeup in here? She's got the tears in the nose.
It's very sweet scene. Every girl wants to hear that, you know, that you remember.
It was a very nice scene. And you, obviously, you guys have such great chemistry on screen.
Yeah.
But one of the reasons, you know, as being an actor myself, is it really makes a difference when you get along great in real life, too. You guys are good friends.
Yep.
But that said, it was a little awkward in one particular scene where you found yourself kind of fanboying out a little bit.
Well, yeah. You know, again, not to give too much of a spoiler, but at the end, you know, I had heard that Lost in Your Eyes was a big part of this film, and, you know, everybody was excited to hear that.
Which was a huge Debbie Gibson
that's
hit.
That's huge.
Exactly.
Huge.
And I always loved that song, and I always listened to it on the radio,
right,
you know,
or
saw a video. And it wasn't until the moment when they were shooting this, we were shooting the scene, when all of a sudden it dawned on me that, oh, wait, she sings this in front of, like, huge crowds, and, like, millions of people around the world have listened to this over decades, and she's singing it one-on-one to me right now, and thanks to television, I get to hear it more than once, and I get to see what a consummate pro she is.
Right.
You know, I knew her as a friend, but to see her really, like, bam, bam, every time,
knock it out,
hitting it like it was the first time,
and a woman right there.
I loved it every time.
You know a thing or two about leaving people starstruck as well, Mr. Robert Gant. You're being very humble. But, you know, you know your way around the block. Tell us a little bit about your time as the very iconic Good Humor Man.
Come on.
Ah, okay,
I love
okay. Yeah, well, I don't know if you know that I had been sort of a lawyer before all of this, and you know, was sort of always drawn to be sort of an advocate in my life.
Really?
So, getting to be the Good Humor Man was getting to be a whole different kind of advocate this time for, you know, good humor. And I went through a long, rigorous process to get selected, and it was then the 75th anniversary. I think now it might be like the 95th anniversary or something of Good Humor Ice Cream. But he was an American icon, you know.
Yeah. And your character.
Well, I got to step in the shoes of this American icon that you know, I and so many people, you know, used to drive around all the neighborhoods in the trucks in America. And you know, one of the really beautiful things about it was we did a big campaign at the time. And I got to do singing and dancing in this.
The commercial was amazing.
We're going to go to the clip in a second.
But I got to go to children's hospitals, you know, around the country.
What's better than that?
And it was an incredible thing just to see, you know, the change and the looks on their faces go from the challenges to this moment of joy of having the good human man walk in with some ice cream.
I love this commercial.
It's great. We saw a still with you. But let's go to the clip of the commercial. Do we have that up and running? We got to check this out.
I'm a good human man. I'm the only man with the ice cream pan. I'm taking my ice cream across the land. Start strawberry shortcake, a chocolate eclair. Start to toast the almond with a savoir faire. Cook a cookie sandwich with a chocolate chip. How about a Sunday cone that'll make you flip? I'm a good human man.
Very catchy. And like you said earlier, you're a very good dancer.
You got some moves.
Oh, thank you.
Love of dance started very early, like around fifth grade.
It did.
Kids were performing in their school plays in front of their parents. Yeah. You, however, were performing in the fifth grade with the iconic, none other, once-in-a-lifetime man, Bob Hope.
Yeah. It's funny. I mean, here I was a kid, and his movies had come out long before, and I'd seen them in reruns, and I knew who he was, and I was aware of the, you know, all his time doing the USO shows overseas, and so it was to do a USO show in Tampa at MacDill Air Force Base, and they, you know, I was tap dancing and whatnot at the time, and so I did a soft shoe routine with Bob Hope, and it was. It was so special, yeah. I think in part because of the service member component. As I think back, we were on the base, and to get just a little taste of what he had done for so many years.
Possibly even means more to you now, knowing what having a better perspective on it than when you were back in the fifth grade. But dancing is still a very 100%. Big part of your life. You recently. Yeah. Just turned
a big birthday. I had a big birthday.
Yeah, a big birthday recently.
It's the new 25. I don't know if you've seen
it. It's great. I love every year. Every year, exactly. I'm grateful for every year.
You look at him. I should be saying it with enthusiasm. You look amazing for 50. But one of the things that you want to make sure you incorporate into that celebration was lots of dancing.
Yes. I love dancing. You know, it's one of those things that just, since I was a kid, just lights me up, as you can see from the Good Humor Man and whatnot. I feel so, you know.
Oh, is this video from the party?
Yes, this is from,
oh, I love it.
Yes, this was me dancing.
Happy 50th.
I had danced at my friend's wedding, and I was so committed that I was going to do it at my 50th. And in truth, there's you know, at the end of the day, it's all about connection and play, and that's what dancing
and having
means.
Fun. It keeps.
I'm
going to
do
young.
It every big birthday.
And it keeps you young, right?
Yeah, for sure.
You got a lot of great stories. A lot of great stuff happened. Congratulations. Always great to see you. Keep dancing.
Thank you.
Invite us to the dance party next year?
Yeah. 100%.